Android Studio 3.0 is finally ready for download in the stable channel. It brings about many improvements that will make developer experience smoother, but also some important changes that might require attention. Android Studio 3 is the first release in which we've added Kotlin support out of the box, and we plan on fully supporting it going forward. Kotlin is a fun and expressive language that has grown popular with Android developers. Thanks to high interoperability with existing Java code, you can now immediately start using it in your apps. We continue to support the Java programming language, and in the newest Android Gradle plugin, we're enabling developers to use Java 8 language features in their code and libraries. We have built bytecode transformations, called the Sugar, into the default toolchain, and it supports lambdas, method references, default and static interface methods, and try with resources, and new annotation types on all API levels. The experimental Jack compiler is now deprecated, and migrating is as simple as removing it from your build files. With the new Android Gradle plugin version 3, we are also bringing performance enhancements to the build process, such as delayed dependency resolution, more incremental dexing, and faster sync times. We're also bringing variant awareness for library modules, which unfortunately meant we had to make some breaking changes to our Gradle DSL, so please follow the migration steps in the documentation when switching to 3.0. Especially developers with large multi-module projects should see a significant decrease in build times with these changes. Starting with this release, we are switching to AAPT2 for resource processing, which enables more incremental and parallelized builds, and even some potential size savings in the resources file, without any changes required to your projects. Thanks to automatic version collapsing, resource deduplication, and support for sparse configurations on MinSDK 26. On the IDE side, we're making changes to help developers bring Android Oreo features to their apps. We've added support for font resources, which you can now create and preview in the Fonts Resource folder. The Layout Editor also lets you pick fonts from the Google Fonts catalog and attach them to your projects. For creating adaptive launcher icons introduced in Android Oreo, open the Asset Studio and select the foreground and background images that you'd like to use. We've also included Android emulator images running Android Oreo, so you can test your changes. To make it easier to set up and maintain CI servers, we have also launched Google's Maven repo as a place where we distribute Google's build artifacts. You can start using it by adding the Maven repo URL to your Gradle files. Debugging performance problems with your apps is also about to get a lot better, thanks to the new unified Android profiler in Studio. It lets you inspect CPU, memory, and network usage, and includes a single timeline that also shows important app events, such as key presses, taps, and rotations. With advanced profiling, you can record CPU traces, track object allocations, and dig into heap dumps in the memory profiler. And this is completely new, by the way. You can show requests and response information and payloads for HTTP calls that were made using one of the supported clients. For now, we support HTTP URL connection and OKHTTP, as well as any client using these under the hood. If you're writing C or C++ code in another IDE, or perhaps you're using other tools such as game engine toolkits to build your APK, you can now use the Android Studio native debugger with your app. Open the APK for debugging, attach the debug symbols and sources, and you will be able to step through code just as with an app developed inside Studio. 3.0 is the first release to support creation of instant apps from your Android projects. There are two new module types, Instant App and Feature. Together with a new refactoring system, they help modularize your app, while the App Links Assistant helps set up the necessary App Links support. If you run into any problems when testing Instant App builds, we've updated the APK Analyzer to open zip bundles. But that's not all. APK Analyzer's Dex Viewer now supports loading ProGuard mapping files to show removed and retained classes, and can generate ProGuard keep rules. It also has an improved user interface showing Dex code sizes, lets you explore method usages, inspect bytecode, and supports multi-dex. Starting with Build Tools 26.1, you can also get all these features in the brand new command line version of the APK Analyzer, which is great for generating reports and tracking APK size regressions on a CI server. When working with layouts, you can now iterate faster using the Layout Editor and Layout Inspector, which are both getting some updates. The editor includes a new error panel showing problems such as missing constraints, and support for new constraint layout features, such as barriers, groups, and enhanced change creation. And the inspector received a UI refresh, and quick search for the properties list and the view tree. If you need to pull files from a device or emulator, try the Device File Explorer, a much more user-friendly way to browse the connected file system than using ADB from a command line. We've also had some important improvements in the Android emulator since the last release of Studio, and that includes new system images with full Play Store, OpenGL ES 3.0 compatibility, a proxy settings page, and a bug reporting tool. There are many, many new things to play with in this release of Android Studio. Have fun exploring and check out the other videos detailing some of the features in this release.